Australian super.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Disappoint?
No.
The drive was worth it?
Yes.
If we're a bit tired, feel free to have a little siesta this afternoon or any time because we've got a fair bit of driving today.
But Laurie can't sleep.
No, Laurie, sorry, you can't sleep. Yesterday afternoon when we had our free time, was everyone practicing for the talent contest?
No.
So over a little 5.5-6 hour drive today, we've got plenty of time to work out our poems, our songs, whether we can do a headstand, whatever our talent might be. But anyway, sit back and relax and enjoy until we get to Lee Creek.
about 5 minutes and we're at Lee Creek.
Welcome to Lee Creek. We're heading into the tourist centre to meet a lady by the name of Joanne. She's doing an informative talk about the area in a short video. Might stop to have a bit of morning tea before heading off again to the Prairie Hotel, which is only probably about away from here. So we'll be here for about an hour, hour and a half. Stretch our legs.
Yeah. Grant Aid and Manage by other groups, you know, that like Aboriginals, not non-Aboriginals, but the Foxes, you know. So that was one of our biggest things, having our grant by the White for what he needed with this chapter, with this country, you know. I suppose as Aboriginal, non-Aboriginals coming together and fighting for what we believe in, and that we should agree that people from Chinese and all them to come and take over Australia. And then they take over, what are we going to do in Australia? It's pretty good. Cool. I've only been back here since for 4 years now. Yeah, I was at Port Augusta living. Yeah, that year I actually had to take my young son over to Sydney for a bone marrow transplant.
Yeah,
okay. So when we got okay to move back, we moved back because of him. Because I thought nothing better than going through all of that, bone marrow transplant, and nothing better for him to come back to his own country. Since then, he's been living life, you know, he's been doing really well with his health and all that. Yes, being back on country, it's great. It's a real challenge for me because I try to gain employment. I think it's just people, because myself and Joanne, we seem to be not quite alright because of our mouth. So, the person that speaks up quite regularly, you know, they think no community wants a loud mouth person in the community. Anyway, it's been really well here. And I've only just experienced a couple of days that where's one of our stories on the Mokanu, the surfer. I've actually been seen in the lights, which is kind of telling me more about the culture, and now it's now run by a new bird. Gasification, he's heard of that, and what he has done with other places, like in New South Wales, I think, oh, Queensland. I'm not quite sure, I'm still feeling the balance of whether we should have a year or but, this is part of the so where are you sitting right now?
Thank you.
thank you for coming in for leading the party.
Exactly. You could call theirs a hard life, but they like it. It's man's work, and it brings man's pay. With the money you can get for your sheep at auction in the towns, for this is range, towns like four.
Still get the history, but you get the new version. And so mixed grill, so bit of a combination of camel, kangaroo, and emu. So now we're there for lunch, so I'm not quite sure what we're having. But that is Parachuna's claim to fame, the Rarey Hotel. And it was established about 1863 when the government built a well out there. But then the government put the rail line through to Farina and to service Blinman with the copper. And so they moved the town 10 kilometres to be closer to the rail, which most of them did. So, but with the rail, the town's died. So. Remember Isaiah talked about the fact that they were looking at World Heritage listing and a new what's it called?
The Wonder of the World.
Yeah, somewhere. The new conservation park which they've applied for. And the reason for that is that about 1950s, a geologist was out kicking some stones out the back near the old mine, and he found some fossils, and those fossils were sea-like creatures. And then a guy bought a farm with his wife, and they found some on the farm, and you may have heard that like in the last. I can't remember when I heard of it. I remember seeing a documentary thing on TV about these people that bought the farm out here and found fossils on the farm. Well, they just happened to be the people that own the Prairie Hotel, where we go for lunch. And so there'll no doubt be some information in the hotel for us to have a look at. But they've actually given away 2/3 of their property to the South Australian government and are joining with the government to try and set up that new conservation park. And yeah, it's the same thing. And they say that these sea creatures that they found the fossils of are the first creatures. Now, I'm not talking a religious thing or anything like that, but as far as, they're talking 550 million years old, and it's the oldest life form ever discovered on this planet. And so, at the moment anyway, the oldest life or evidence of life form started here. And which I think is pretty amazing, in the Flinders, in our backyard. But I'm sure at the Prairie Hotel there'll be a bit more information. We'll be there in about 40 minutes. And so sit back, relax. Here we go. Just shows you how important. Oh, this guy's stopped to get his fever. He's getting his own firewood. That'll be well, a bit of red gum. As you do, yeah. Just shows you in those early days how important the rail was. Now look, they're all getting sleepy. They're all getting their firewood. So the rail really brought life to this area. When they closed the rail down, the town, as Serena just said, that Lee Creek, 3,000 people, well, that's a decent sized town. And but then they brought in the fly in, fly out, and so I think it halved to about 1,500 while they were doing the fly in, fly out. And then when they closed the mine, it's down to 150. But you can buy a house for $32,000 if you want to live in Green Creek. Yep.
Yeah, that's
sorry. So that's where we came out from Blinden.
Absolutely amazing and beautiful, and it really was.
Yeah.
There wasn't a meal we had.
When we do check in, the office did say to me if we get time when we arrive to have a quick look at the bird at Petersburg News Agency if we get time. So yeah, we should be on time and have a little look before we check in.
These towns are built around the pubs and the inns.